Okay, welcome. In the last class, I have given you a numerical to work out. I hope you all have done it. So, let us discuss its solution now. I have given you f of x is equal to 1 by 1 plus x whole square to expand in binomial series. Okay. This we can write it as 1 plus x to the power minus 2, right. So, in terms of binomial expansion, we can write it as 1 at x is equal to 0, f of x is 1, then our minus 2 by 1 factorial into 1 plus x to the power minus 3 m by 1 factorial, m is here minus 2. Our in a binomial expansion 1 plus x to the power m, here m is equal to here minus 2. Okay. So, m by 1 factorial into x, then the next term is m into m minus 1 means minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3 by 2 factorial into x square. The next fact is m into m minus 1 into m minus 1 is minus 3, m minus 2 is minus 4 divided by 3 factorial x cube. The next term is m into m minus 1 is minus 3, m minus 2 is minus 4, m minus 4 is minus 5 divided by 4 factorial into x to the power 4, sure, right. So, this is equal to 1 minus 2 x, then this is minus minus plus 2 cancels out. So, it is plus 3 x square. The next term is 3 factorial is 3 into 2. So, they will cancel minus minus plus. So, it is minus 4 x cube. Then 4 factorial is 4, 3 into 2. So, they all cancel and only this minus minus plus minus minus plus. So, it is plus plus 5 x 4, so on, right. So, you can see if we write it in a summation symbol, then when it is x to the power 1, this is our 1 plus 1. Okay. When this is x to the power 2, this is 2 plus 1. When it is x to the power 3, it is 3 plus 1, shown. So, in general, it is k plus 1 into x to the power k. Is it all right? When I write x to the power 2, it is the coefficient is 3, 2 plus 1. When x to the power 3, it is 4, 3 plus 1. So, when I write in general term x to the power k, it will be k plus 1. Okay. And then this sign alternates. I mean, when k is 1, it is minus 1. When k is 2, it is plus. When k is 3, it is minus. When k is 4, it is plus. So, in general, we can write it as minus 1 to the power k, so that for every odd value of k, it is minus. For even value of k, it is plus. So, we can write it as minus 1 to the power k. Okay. So, this is equal to this much summation k is equal to 0 to infinity. So, our 1 by 1 plus x whole square, when expanded in terms of binomial series, the expansion is this summation k is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 to the power k into k plus 1 into x to the power k. Okay. So, this way we can express different functions in terms of Taylor series, Maclaurin series and binomial series. Okay. And in the beginning of this, the discussion of this series expansion, I have told you that these are nothing but an approximation, a power series approximation of a function or polynomial approximation of a function. So when you write f of x in terms of a polynomial approximation, if you take first two terms, the approximation is less. Means if you plot the graph between graph 1 minus 2x and the exact function 1 by 1 plus x square, the overlapping area will be less. As you take into account more number of terms in this power series, the graphs will approximate to the original function. Okay. And if you terminate it into a finite number of terms, then there will be always a remainder. That remainder is called truncation error, right. So, when we reduce or when we curtail the power series to a finite number of terms, we eventually get an error or residue. That is called truncation error. Okay. So, if we expand it in terms of infinite series, the entire series curve will match with the original curve. So, the purpose of this power series expansion is that every function can be approximated as a polynomial of high order expansion. Okay. For example, if we draw this graph f of x is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square. The graph is when x is equal to 0, f x is equal to 1. So, the intercept is here, right. As x increases, the function value decreases. Okay. So, the graph is like this and it is always positive. So, it is always along positive y axis, right. And suppose in this binomial expansion, we will only take 3 terms, polynomial of order 3, okay. or say we will take 4 terms. Okay. Then, and if we plot, if we plot 1 minus 2x plus 3x square minus 4x cube, then the curve will be like this. Okay. So, up to 4 terms in this power series, our approximation is up to this point. The curve matches with the original curve up to this point. If we take more term, the closer it will be to the original curve, means error will be less, this truncation error will be less. So, when we consider the infinite number of terms, it finally expresses the original function. This is the beauty of power series expansion, or we can say in general polynomial expansion, polynomial approximation. Okay. So, with this we end this power series expansion, Taylor series, binomial series. Now, we will discuss a very important branch of calculus which has got a very wide and immense applications in physics, different branches of physics. In fact, most of the fundamental equations in physics are expressed in terms of this language we call differential equation, right. So, differential equation, what is a differential equation? Differential equation. An equation involving one or more derivatives of an unknown function. Unknown function is called a differential equation. It's called a differential equation. The order of the highest derivative, the order of the highest derivative in this equation is the order of the differential equation. Okay. So, if an equation involves one or more derivatives of an unknown function, it is called differential equation, and the highest derivative of the function is the order of the equation, right. So, in physics we have come across with many differential equations. We all are familiar with mechanics, and the entire classical mechanics is based on Newton's second law of motion, which is nothing but a second order differential equation, because if r is the position vector of a particle, this is the coordinate system, and if r is the position vector of a particle, and if the particle moves, then r is a function of time, so that the rate of change of r with respect to time is the velocity, and the rate of change of velocity is the acceleration, that is equal to d square r by dt square. And Newton's second law says that force on the particle is equal to mass times its acceleration, that is m into d square r by dt square. Okay. So, this equation involves the second order derivative of the position vector r. So, r here is a function of time. Okay. And this equation is nothing but a second order differential equation. Why we called it second order differential equation? Because this difference, the highest derivative is second derivative. So, the order of the derivative is 2 and order of the differential equation is 2, right. So, in quantum mechanics, we also similarly deal with a second order differential equation called Schrodinger equation. So, in the heat equation, in every branch, almost every branch of physics, we come across with a differential equation that involves an unknown derivatives of unknown function, and our task is to solve this differential equation so that we can know the function value. Okay. So, in the subsequent discussion, we shall deal with how to solve this differential equation. If the differential equation involves only single derivative, it is called a first order differential equation. Okay. And if the power is 1, then it is called linear differential equation. So, linear first order differential equation. So, let us now first we confine our discussion to first order linear differential equation. Okay. The simplest first order linear differential equation. The simplest first order linear differential equation is in the form dy by dx is equal to q of x, right. Y as a function of x, so that dy by dx is equal to q of x. For example, let us give an example. Dy by dx is equal to x cube. This is a first order linear differential equation. I mean first order because derivative is one derivative, first derivative only. There is not higher order derivatives. So, derivative is first order, and the power of this highest order derivative is called the degree of the equation, and if degree is 1, it is linear differential equation. Okay. So, it is very easy to solve this differential equation, because if dy by dx is equal to x cube, then y is equal to simply integration of x cube dx, that is equal to x to the power 4 by 4 plus a constant c. this constant comes because of this indefinite integration. Okay. So, this is the solution of this differential equation, which we can find out very easily. But always we do not get those differential equations while dealing with any physical problems in such a simpler form. We generally do not get it. So, we have to bring it to a form so that we can solve it easily. I mean, our purpose is we can separate y and x variable so that we can integrate both sides independently. Okay. And always this, the general solution is a set of equations for different values of c, right? C comes constant of integration. And always when we solve a differential equation, we must check that the validity of the equation. The equation is valid if we put this in the equation, it must satisfy the original differential equation. So, if we put this in this differential equation, then our dy by dx is nothing but dy by dx is nothing but 1 by 4 into 4 into x cube plus derivative of constant is 0. So, it is equal to x cube. So, definitely it must satisfy this differential equation. Then we will accept it as a general solution. Okay. Then the general form of a first order linear differential equation, the general form is dy by dx plus a function of x into y is equal to q of x. Okay. This is the general form of first order linear differential equation. And the problem or numerical we discussed just now is dy by dx is equal to x cube is just a special case of this one, where our p of x is 0. Okay. Suppose I give an example, dy by dx plus x square into y is equal to e to the power x. Okay. Then this equation is again a first order linear differential equation, where our p of x is x square. Right. Here p of x is 0, but here p of x is x square. Okay. So, let us now discuss how to solve a differential equation which is in this form, that is dy by dx plus p of x into y is equal to q of x. Let us say this is equation 1. We want to solve it. Okay. To solve this first order linear differential equation, we will adopt a technique called integrating factor method. Okay. Now let us define a function like mu is equal to e to the power integration of p dx. This is the equation 2. Let us introduce this term. Mu is equal to e to the power integration p dx. Okay. Then what will be the d value of d mu by dx? D mu by dx. Okay. Derivative of e to the power something with respect to that is the same, e to the power integration of p dx into derivative of integration of p dx. Okay. And we know integration is the antiderivative. So, integration of p and again differentiation of p is the same function p. Okay. So, it is equal to e to the power integration of p dx into p of x. that is p of x into e to the power integration of p dx. This is d mu by dx. Okay. Now, let us find d by dx of mu into y. Okay. D by dx of mu into y. Then we will use the product rule. This is equal to mu into dy by dx plus y into d mu by dx. And already we have found out the value of d mu by dx. It is nothing but px into e to the power integration of p dx. So, let us substitute this. Then it becomes mu into dy by dx plus px into plus y into p of x into e to the power integration of p dx. Let us say this is equation 3. Okay. And this integration of e into integration of p dx is nothing but mu. This is also this in e to the power integration of p dx is what? It is as according to equation 2, it is mu. So, it is actually nothing but mu into p of x. Okay. So, you can write it as y into mu into p of x. This is equation 3. Okay. So, our equation 3 is, let us write it in another step. This implies d by dx of mu y is equal to mu into dy by dx plus y mu p of x, equation 3. If we multiply mu with equation 1, okay, what we will get? Let us multiply mu into equation 1. We will get mu into dy by dx plus mu plus here it is y into mu into p of x is equal to mu into q of x. Okay. This is equation 4. So, you can see from equation 3 and equation 4, the left side, I mean the RHS of equation 3 is nothing but the LHS of equation 4. Therefore, we are arriving at d by dx of mu y is equal to mu into q x, okay? Because this mu into dy by dx plus y into mu into p of x is equal to mu into q of x. So, for this value, we will substitute from equation 4 mu into q x. Therefore, from equation 3 and equation 4, from equation 3 and equation 4, equation 3 and equation 4, we get d by dx of mu y, okay, d by dx of mu y is equal to this, this value becomes mu into q x is equal to mu into q of x. Okay. This is equation 5. Now, let us integrate the above equation with respect to x. Integrating the above equation with respect to x with respect to x, we get the left hand side is mu y is equal to integration of mu q of x dx, okay, or y is equal to 1 by mu integration of mu cube of x dx. This is the general solution of our differential equation, first order differential equation in the form equation 1. Okay. And here, so this is the general solution, and mu, which is equal to e to the power integration of v dx, is called integrating factor. So this is the way we can solve any first order linear differential equation that is in the form of equation 1. So any first order linear differential equation in the form of equation 1 has a general solution y is equal to 1 by mu integration of mu qx dx, where mu is equal to integration of p dx is called integration factor. Okay. So we have now discussed first order differential equation. For higher order derivatives or differential equations, we shall see how different techniques will be applied. So let us end this class here. Thank you very much.